practically live, emanating from high atop the commercial exhibit building at the Dyer County Fairgrounds. It's Fair TV with your hosts, Debbie Bradshaw Hart and Eric Maupin. And now, cheaper than Prozac, without all those crazy side effects, here's Debbie Bradshaw Hart and Eric Maupin.
Wow, welcome to the 2016 Dyer County Fair. We're already here again, starting off tonight with our opening ceremonies. Eric,
wow.
Here we go.
Monday night at the Dyer County Fair. I absolutely love it. Can you believe it's already been a year?
No, I can't. We were talking about this earlier. Charles Dawson used to always say, can you believe it's been a year, Debbie?
That's right. And you know, the sad thing is, I look a year older. Debbie, you don't.
Oh, I love
you. Don't look,
with you.
You don't
so
look.
Fun.
You don't look any older.
Yeah, thank you. It's lots of good makeup and all the people do your hair and all that.
That's right. That's right. Yeah, Chuck gets in here and Paul and does your makeup.
They
I don't
do.
Get any makeup. I don't have a makeup staff. I haven't gotten to that level yet, but you have. So yeah.
Well, there you go. We'll work on that for in the next hour to see if we can help you out a little bit. We have so much for you this week here at the Dyer County Fair. We have got concerts, we have got beauty pageants, we've got truck and tractor pulls. What else?
It's a big thing. And tonight here at the Dyer County Fair, Monday night, we've got the beef cattle show that's going on right now. A lot of big stuff going on. There's new stuff here at the fair.
There is new stuff.
All sorts of new stuff, all sorts of new rides. We have a new carnival that's here this year, and I think you're really, really, really going to like them.
We were talking earlier about how many new rides they have this year, and we have a new carnival this year, amusement attractions, and they do have more rides than even the ones did last year, so we're looking for a very good year this year.
Yes, and just to give you a sneak peek, we're going to be going out there and showing you all the new big rides that are going on. It is fantastic, especially for the older kids. We've still got all the major rides for the small kids. But the bigger kids and young adults, we've got some awesome rides. Those that'll make you sick. No. I'm too
old.
We
did grow up.
Yes.
Yes.
Do know
you're not supposed to ride those things.
If I show up here one night and I'm green, then you know.
Exactly. One thing that we have new this year is the selfie contest, which I'm not real sure how that's all going to work, but you need to go to our website, dyercofair.com, and that will give you all the details that you need.
Selfie contest. Every night we're going to give away $50 to the winner for the selfie winner.
That's
so make sure to go to the website and do that. And check this show out. We're also going to be airing. Check us out on Twitter, Facebook, and our website.
That's right. And also, if you haven't figured it out yet, on Cable One, it's channel 56. On UVerse, it's 99. And on Charter Spectrum, it is 156.
Very good.
Plus our website and Facebook and everywhere else. So if you can't see the Dyer County Fair, it's just because you don't open your eyes.
That's right.
Exactly. All right, then. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's go down to the amphitheater and let's see how our president this year, Sandy Baker, is handling the opening ceremonies.
Good evening. What a great day, Labor Day 2016. We have so much to be thankful for right here in Dyer County. All the entries are in, the carnival lights are getting ready to turn on, the funnel cakes are frying, the crop building is brimming, the beef cows are showing, and all of this just gives me goosebumps. Welcome. And welcome to the 2016 Dyer County Fair. It is my privilege to be your 2016 Fair President, and it is an honor for me to do that. It is my pleasure at this time to introduce the Color Guard from Dyer County High School's ROTC. Thank you. At this time, Casey Baker is coming to sing our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming? whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
This year's theme, the Dyer County Fair, a volunteer tradition, is a tribute to all who make this great event possible. This fairgrounds has been buzzing for the past few weeks as our fair board members and our community volunteers have worked hard to make this year's fair the best it can be. The Dyer County Fair is officially open. There's lots going on already. The fairest of the fair pageant contestants are getting ready to take the stage. My wish is for everyone to have a great, safe, fun week at the Dyer County Fair.
Well, there you have it. It's official. The 2016 Dyer County Fair is off and running. Can't wait for this week's events.
We're ready to go.
And we are.
This morning, I had the opportunity to speak with some kids entering their crops that they grew into the Sam Reed's Crops building and showing their exhibits. And also, this year, for the first time, Kid Davy, the illusionist. We'll have all of this and more coming up right after this.
It's the Dyer County Fair, September 5th through the 10th. With carnival rides and midway, truck and tractor pool, Dyer County Can Dance Showcase, selfie contest all week, $1,000 drawing every night, reviews, contests, judging, cook-offs, car giveaway, and more. Mo Pitney and William Michael Morgan in concert. It's the Dyer County Fair, September 5th through the 10th. Entry forms, admission prices, and schedule of events at dyercofair.com. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter.
You know, this evening we also have the Fairest of the Fair going on and the Junior Fairest of the Fair. So tomorrow night, hopefully, we'll have her on our show. We've got a live concert tomorrow night in the amphitheater sponsored by Jack FM. It's going to be a great concert out there, too. And then Wednesday?
Well, I have to stop and say this. We have a lot of beauty reviews going on all
yes,
throughout
we do.
The week.
That's just
absolutely
part of a county
no
fair.
That's right. And the beauty reviews are wonderful. But we also have beauty reviews of not just humans, but also livestock.
That's right. We
do. Today, Monday night, we're having the beef cattle show. Tomorrow, that will go on as well, the heifer show. And that's just a beauty pageant in itself.
It really is. And unless you've been to the Ag Barn and you see these animals, they treat those animals just like royalty. And their coats are beautiful and their hooves and everything. So it's a big deal here at the county fair.
Agriculture is a big deal in West Tennessee and all over the surrounding area, Arkansas, mm-hmm. Boot Hill of Missouri. We take pride in that here. You see these animals come from everywhere. They wash them, they shampoo their
they
hair,
do.
They blow dry them, they get them all fixed up, and then they show them. So it's really a neat thing to see. And also, not just livestock, but we take care of our crops. We've got corn on each side of us.
Mm-hmm.
We've got some video coming up of the kids that entered their crops, whether it be from their garden, whether it be from their field, if their parents farm, if their grandfather farmed. So anyway, let's go to that right now and show some video of these kids.
Sounds
and
good.
How exciting they are because they've spent all summer growing these crops and then they're getting ready to judge them. Now you want to talk about prepared. Y'all came prepared. It looks like you've done this before. Now who am I talking with? What's your name?
Jane.
All right.
Kim Childers.
Yes, right here we are. And I've got to say, this is brilliant. You've got your little cart. It's full of the crops you're going to enter. And they look good, by the way.
And they're in order.
In order.
In order. We go from the top to the bottom.
There you go. She's done a good job. Now, can you tell me some of the stuff you're entering today? What have you got here? What's this?
John.
Cotton, yeah, and corn and soybeans. Now, is this something you've done before?
I've done this for years.
Don't you love it?
My grandson. I done for my sons, and they in their 30s.
How about that? So the tradition continues, right?
Yes.
And what do we do with the money? Are you going to ride any rides this week? All right, here you have it. Entering crops, we're going to have fun. We're going to ride rides. And I hope that you get a blue ribbon.
I hope we do too.
Good.
We'll get a bunch.
There you go. Thank you all so much. And go enter your crops. I have a good feeling about this. I think you're going to get all blue. All right, we're here at the Sam Reed's Agricultural Crops Building, and I've got a family here doing the family tradition. Starting one, entering crops. Can you tell me your name?
All right, and what's your name?
Cooking.
All right, and I assume this is Mom and Dad?
Yes.
Yes.
And what's your name?
Amber.
Amber? Brian.
And Brian. All right, you sure are pretty today. What are you holding? What are you going to enter into the fair today?
Corn?
Yeah, and what about you?
And beans.
Soybeans.
Is that by cotton behind you too? Yep. Now, is this y'all's first year to enter crops into the crops building?
Say yes, sir.
Yes. Yeah,
but now, I assume you're going to do this as long as you can, right?
Say
right.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
How do you like the fair?
Good.
Are you going to ride any rides while you're here?
Yeah.
All right. Here you have it, folks. One big happy family going to enter some crops and make some money, right? Right?
Yeah.
Thank y'all so much. Oh my goodness, the whole back end of the truck is full. Y'all got so many crops that you're entering. Now, who am I speaking with?
Jack.
What's your name?
Oh.
And your name?
Adam Brittany Singletary.
And it looks like y'all got a lot of stuff. Now, I have to notice you had the scissors in your hands. The kids were helping. You're taking the leaves off, which is what the book says to do, so that we can see the fruit that the plants are bearing. So tell me a little bit about what you're entering today.
Well, we have some soybeans and we have some cotton. We also cut off the 6 bales of cotton and put it on the cardboard. We have some sunflowers, some corn, and we have some gourds. And I think, well, we have roses that we're going to enter up there and some flowers, and we enter crafts on Saturday. So.
Wow, and the kids get money for this. Are y'all going to get blue ribbons?
Yeah,
blue ribbons. And are you going to take your money and ride rides?
You are?
What's your favorite ride?
The roller coaster.
The roller coaster. And I love it. Are y'all going to continue to do this forever? All right, there we go. Mom, it looks like you've got a long time to do this. Now, this is, I assume that y'all have been taking advantage of entering the crops and entering the things up in the Family Living Center for a long time. How much fun is it, and what does it teach the kids?
Oh, they love it. Well, he's just big on anything farming, anything that has to do with the field or anything. So he likes to do it, but he's kind of at the age where he just likes to watch. And so Mom has to do it, or Daddy has to do it. But next year, I have decided that he's going to start doing a little bit more of it on his own. But I think it's a good thing, and carrying on the tradition that his daddy started a long time ago.
And probably Daddy, Granddaddy.
Yes, on down the children's line.
That is wonderful. Thank y'all so much, and I have a good feeling about it. I think you're going to have all blue ribbons.
I hope so.
Well, I always love doing that. Those kids seem so excited about bringing their crops into the crop building.
And they are.
That's just an enjoyment. I enjoy doing that.
And that's the good thing about the youth, is because they all win.
That is correct.
Everybody wins in the youth department.
Everybody wins when they come to the Dyer County Fair.
That's right. Well, we have some more footage now of the Kid Davy Show, which is an illusionist here at the Dyer County Fair. So let's see what he's up to.
And that's just a little bit of what Kid Davey is going to do. Hopefully, before the week's over, I'm going to get him to make some people disappear.
There you go. Can we make a list?
That would be wonderful.
Yeah. I'm just kidding. For sure, we have tomorrow night on Tuesday night, we have Pay One Price Night. That's $10. Also, that's on Wednesday night. You pay $10 at the gate to get in, and you ride the rest of the night till 10:30 when the rides stop. And that gives you time to get over to the amphitheater for the $1,000 cash drawing that we have nightly.
$1,000 a night. And if for some reason the first ticket they draw on the money, it drops it in half to $500.
That's right.
And then someone's going to win that $500, but that $500 then goes to Saturday night. And Saturday night, by the way, wow, the concert. You cannot miss it. Mo Pitney and William Michael Morgan.
That's
is that right.
right? That is right.
And listen, I didn't know who they were. I mean, I'd heard the names, but then when I heard their songs, I knew exactly what their songs were. These guys are phenomenal. They're great. So make sure that you're here.
Yes.
They're really superstars.
They are. They're really good guys, and they're young and upcoming. Been around here for not very long now.
That's right.
So way to get them headed out here with the Dyer County Fair, because we like to get people out here to the fair and see new acts for us. And we also want you to be sure that if you haven't seen them before, if you haven't seen any of the footage on our show, if you'll go to our website, we have a video on there of them, of Mo and also of William Michael Morgan.
Yes, the videos are on there. Also, our nightly shows are on there. Our website, we have really added everything to our website. Make sure you go to that. We're on Facebook, we're on Twitter. Send us your selfies.
That's
we
right.
We want your selfies. We want to show everyone how much fun you're having here at the fair. And we want you to send them so much that we are actually doing a contest every night. We're going to give $50 away to the selfie winner.
That's
and I
right.
said it, selfie contest winner. There
That's
we go.
Right. Yeah, and we'll post the winners on our website so you can look there every day. And at nighttime, our show will be uploaded, I believe is what you call it, to our website. So you can see this on our website anytime during the day or night, just whenever you want to watch it.
Yep. So make sure to stand by. We've got a lot of stuff going on. This week is cram-packed full of stuff going on. It's new stuff. We've got a new carnival, amusement
attractions.
Attractions. Uh-huh. I knew I would mess that up. Amusement attractions, first time ever. Here at the Dyer County Fair, you're going to love them. They've got the newest and best rides out there. Something for everyone. As I've said before, whether you're 8 or 80, you're going to love the Dyer County Fair, so make sure to come down.
Yes, you're exactly right. Then, of course, then on Thursday night, we still have more pageants going on, and we have a new thing this year called Dyer County Can Dance. If you'd like more information about it, go to our webpage and you can find out about how to enter that. Also on Friday, we have Kids Day. We have our truck and tractor pull, a new car giveaway at 10:30, a $1,000 drawing. It just keeps on getting better and better as the week goes.
What more could you ask for? So here it is, Dyer County Fair. Make sure to come on down. We also want to thank our sponsor of the day, Hometown Urgent Care. It is Monday at the Dyer County Fair. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back.
It's the Dyer County Fair, September 5th through the 10th, with carnival rides at Midway, corn dogs, cotton candy, and more. Beauty pageants for all ages, go-kart racing, $1,000 giveaway every night, win a new car, plus other great fair events all week. And don't miss Mo Pitney and William Michael Morgan in concert. It's the Dyer County Fair, September 5th through the 10th. Entry forms, admission prices, and schedule of events at dyercofair.com. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter.
I am so honored. I have a special guest here with me tonight, Miss Jane Bradshaw. And let me tell you, there are so many people on the fair board that really make this fair a premier fair. And you are one of those people. I have been mesmerized by your talent and your ability over the years. This behind us, the stages that you've seen for many years, you are one of the people responsible for that. Artist is the best way I can describe you. Your ability to come up, take a theme, and be able to do backdrops is unbelievable. So if you don't mind, just tell our viewers and tell everyone here in Dyer County how you got started doing this.
Well, first of all, I will say that is not a one-person job. So you know, the story about the turtle sitting on the fence post. He didn't get there by himself. All right. So, I guess we have always been lovers of the fair and always wanted to be involved. So we were involved when we were actually living in Memphis and coming home Labor Day weekend and working with the fair when it was over at the old fairgrounds, which is Fairview Cemetery. So, of course, when it moved over here and we moved home to Dyersburg in 1989, my uncle, who was Larry Gibson, called and said, well, would you like to be on the fair board? And I said, yes, I would love to be on the fair board. Started out at Primary Crafts up at the Family Living Center, and then just evolved into when we built the new amphitheater. We went a couple of years and then decided, okay, let's come up with a theme for the fair. So we started coming up with themes and doing backdrops.
And that's been a tradition that we're still doing to this day.
Yes.
And very successful, might I add.
Yeah,
I mean, everyone's been.
We've had some. Lisa Bailey started with me in the beginning, and then Joe Jennings helped me at some point. We had lots of different people that helped, and then Jenny Bowman and I were the ones, I guess, that have done it for the last 10, 12 years maybe, that we put it together. And then she moved off to Florida and left me by myself. So.
Well, you do such a wonderful job with that. And it's not just the backdrops. Over the years, I mean, our set here for the Fair TV, I mean, this is something you did years ago, but we kept those. We continue to use them. The buses, for example, I'll never forget, if you've ever ridden the cool bus here at the Dyer County Fair, when you park, you can get on the cool bus. I think we've got some video of that, but that just amazed me. I watch y'all do that. And
you can do a lot with the spray paint cans, though. I mean, it's, I don't know, just one of those things that we enjoy doing, so I guess that we're kind of blessed with that talent to be able to put kind of things like that together, so that's what we enjoy doing.
Well, it's unbelievable. Thank you so much. I have to ask, over the years, is there one backdrop that you've done on the main stage that sticks out in your mind that you had the most fun doing, so to speak? Or they've all been wonderful, but now some of those, if you've remembered, go back in time, if you've been to our fair, some of those are just remarkable. They're just unbelievable. And so is there one that sticks out in your mind?
There's always been a story with each backdrop that we've done. You know, from the beginning one that we were getting fabrics from Dyersburg Fabrics, you know, that we used the first year, and we had torrential downpours two nights before the fair started, so we had this fabric just sagged, so we had to take that fabric down and put new fabric up. So there's always a story with the fair. One year it was 110 heat index, and we're trying to hang a tarp that looks like a tent. I think I provided you with that picture, and it was just ridiculously hot, and I'd had a lot of people that didn't show up after that year that decided they wanted to work inside the building instead of helping
somewhere
set up the
else
stage.
Yeah,
they found somewhere else to go.
Well, I just want you to know, thank you again.
Oh, you're welcome.
I really appreciate what you've done over the years. It's impressed me. It's always been something impressive to watch. So if you see Jane walking around somewhere, thank her, hug her neck, tell her what a wonderful job she does. The backdrop looks good this year. It looks great. Everything looks great. Everything you've done over the years.
We've come to simplify over the last several years just because I had bought a business and I own a retail business, so I don't have as much time during the day to try to get prepared for the show and getting the stage ready. So, and it simplified. The girls didn't like as much competition with their dresses when they come out on stage, so we kind of simplified it over the years, which has worked good since Jenny left me and moved to Florida. It's worked good for me when I'm doing it by myself, but I don't know, this might be my last year doing the stage. I think I've got a couple other people, Virginia Porter, and I think Stacey Williams might take it over next year, and I'll find another spot to do something. So,
well,
anyway.
Another example of our volunteers that it takes to put on our Dyer County Fair, and I can't say it enough. Thank you so much for your years of service, and I will have to say you still amaze me. Your artistic ability and the way that you can take a piece of cardboard and make it look so wonderful just blows my mind.
Allen Stone, which used to be Allen Stone Box Factory in Halls, has always been so nice to provide us with all the cardboard, the white cardboard that we've always painted and used, and we'd haul a trailer up there and bring 10, 12 sheets of cardboard back and we'd get started. So anyway, we thank them for giving that to us all those years. So anyway, that's kind of the story of the stage. We come up with a theme and something that everybody can work with, and the commercial building, something that will be easily, anybody could come up with an idea for that. So, and we came up, Sandy and I came up this year with the volunteer tradition, which we thought that was a great one for this year, just because it is a volunteer thing. And, you know, a lot of people think we get free passes, we get free t-shirts, we get all these things for free, which we don't.
No.
I pay for a pass just like everybody else does. I pay for a t-shirt. And this year, I actually sent the staple gun through my wrist when I had a staple gun that was a little different. And I was out here stapling one day and punctured my wrist, had a little snake bite there. And when I pulled it out, I thought, okay, I think I need to go get a tetanus shot. So I went, ran myself over and got a tetanus shot, and $50 later, I'm still volunteering. So.
Well, and you can't go anywhere. We need you. We have to have you.
Oh, well, I'll be doing something, unless it's a ball game weekend, you know.
So. That's right.
Anyway.
Well, thank you so much again, and we'll be back, right back in just a few moments.
It's the Dyer County Fair, September 5th through the 10th, with carnival rides and midway, truck and tractor pull, Dyer County Can Dance Showcase, selfie contest all week, $1,000 drawing every night, reviews, contests, judging, cook-offs, car giveaway, and more. Mo Pitney and William Michael Morgan in concert. It's the Dyer County Fair, September 5th through the 10th. Entry forms, admission prices, and schedule of events at dyercofair.com. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter.
We are back, and you know I really enjoyed interviewing Jane.
She is
so talented.
She is talented.
Kind of makes me mad.
I know.
Some people get it and some people don't.
Well, and she can. She came in here today and we had these little pumpkin things around, and she says, oh, well, here, y'all need something here on this table. We're like, sure, girl, go right ahead.
Effortlessly.
Effortlessly.
She does a good job.
Yes, she does. And speaking of, I think you did talk about our backdrop.
Yes, she
That's
did
right.
that.
Jane, and she freehand painted that. Just painted.
Yeah, I know.
So, good job.
It kind of makes
good interview.
Me mad, but she
enjoyed
does,
it.
She does have that ability, and not just her. We have over 70 fair board members that volunteer their time here, getting everything set up, taking everything down, and we do it simply because we love the fair and what it means to the community and the surrounding counties and the surrounding states. So make sure that you come down. And each and every year, we have a tradition of those fair board members that have meant so much to us and have gone on to be with the Lord. We dedicate the fair and the fair book to them. And there's no exception this year.
Mm-hmm.
We have two individuals that this fair would not be what it is today if it weren't for the countless hours that
That's
these two
right.
individuals gave. And that is Jerry Jackson and Billy G. Stafford. And we're so thankful to them and their families for allowing them over the years, decades that they spent out here at the fair. Now, Jerry Jackson, we're going to showcase him later on in the week. But tonight, we just want to share with you some things about Mr. Billy G. Stafford.
Looking back.
Billy G. Stafford was born in Rowellin, Tennessee in July of 1931. The only son of a tenant farmer, from an early age he was fascinated with agriculture. As a high school student at Dyersburg High School, he was president of the Future Farmers of America and studied with Sam Reed. Sam Reed helped him win a scholarship at UTMB, where he earned a degree in farm science. He was a USDA plant production and quarantine specialist, and in the mid-50s, he became the manager of Calcutt Farms, a large tract of farm south of Dyersburg, and he was that for over 55 years. Mr. Billy was a member of the First United Methodist Church, Sellers Sunday School class, and the men's choir. He was a charter member of the Dyersburg Breakfast Rotary Club, where he served as treasurer and was named a Paul Harris Fellow. He was a Redcoat volunteer at the local hospital, a board member at the Dyer County Literacy Program, and a past president of the UT Alumni Association, and not least of all, an Air Force veteran. Billy and his bride Janice always worked at the Dyer County Fair in whatever capacity they were needed. Billy was a lifetime member of the board of directors, a past president of the Dyer County Fair Association, and he and Janice published a cookbook. It was called From the Back Burner. That became a local favorite. And the proceeds from the sales of that book were donated to the Dyer County Fair Association. He knew all there was to know about cattle, crops, and of course, counting the money from the fair gates late at night. Mr. Billy so enjoyed the magical time at the Dyer County Fair, where a community comes together for the first week in September for fun, food, and fellowship. It's better left to
chance. We're back here at the Dyer County Fair. First night, got lots going on. We've had our opening ceremony, and as I said, it is official. The Dyer County Fair is open. Our carnival opens every day at 5:30, so you need to come on out. Be sure that you take your selfie picture, because that's on $50 for a gift, or for a gift for a prize.
Yeah. $50 a night for the person that sends in the best selfie. And I'm sorry, Debbie could not win Fairest of the Fair that's being chosen right now because
right.
She had to be here on the set. So
well, they don't
you would have won.
Maybe Thursday.
Hands down.
Thursday. That's it. The Senior Citizens Day.
No.
There you go.
No.
We've got lots of things going on this week. And Tuesday, as always, pay one price night for $10. You get in the gate and you ride till closing at 10:30. We have a $1,000 drawing tonight at 10:30 and also tomorrow night, each and every night. We're on Facebook and Twitter, so be sure you get on there and like our page.
Yes, log on all week long. You can not only get to see us, you get to see all the things that are being showcased here at the Dyer County Fair. Tomorrow night's show, you don't want to miss it. We're going to have an interview with the Dyer County, the new 2016 Dyer County Fairest of the Fair. Also,
don't know who she is yet.
Don't know.
Still going on.
But she's going to be beautiful. We know that.
She will be.
And we call her the Dyer County Fairest of the Fair, but she could be from Lake County. She could be from Crockett County.
That's right. That's new this year.
That's new. We want to mention that. We are allowing Crockett County and Lake County. They're kind of our cousins, real
that's
close.
That's right.
And they don't have county fairs, so we're allowing them to enter into the Fairest of the Fair, and we're so
That's
proud
right.
of that. So make sure yeah. that you come out and support your county, regardless of where it is. Also, we'll have the interview of them tomorrow night. Also, we're going to interview the new amusement attractions.
There you go.
Which are our new carnival rides this year. We're going to be showcasing some of the highlights, some of the new rides that they have, all of the things that you come to the fair for. I mean, really, if you want to get sick, they've got the ride for it. If you just want to have fun, they've got the ride for it. If you have small kids, they have the ride for it. So
that's right.
Regardless of what you're into, come to the Dyer County Fair. They have the ride. We're going to showcase those tomorrow.
That's right. Pope's Concessions, of course, is here. So it's fair time in Dyer County.
That's right.
It is.
Also, I want to mention, I think we're going to, on tomorrow's show, you're going to go over to the Family Living Center.
Yes.
And you're going to showcase some of the desserts, is what I call it. But
That's
what do
right.
you actually call it?
It's the culinary department. I had to explain to these guys what culinary is, but anyway, it's all going to work out.
We still don't know what it is. It's those good pies and cakes
That's
and
right.
those things that are made homemade. They're brought here. They judge them on
yes.
all sorts of different things, from
That's
texture
right.
to look.
That's right.
All
and they
things.
Taste all of it.
Yes.
So
and I wish I could be a judge, but I wouldn't know what I was judging except that it tastes good and looks good.
That's right.
So you're going to interview some folks over there.
I will.
Showcase some of the culinary department. And also, last but not least, on tomorrow night's show, Mo Pitney. We're going to give you kind of a little highlight of what's going to go in there, because he's going to be live in concert Saturday night here at the Dyer County Fair.
That's right. Looking forward to it. Well, Eric, I guess we need to close out the show for tonight. And we hope you've enjoyed it. We've done a little bit different format this year. And anyway, we're looking forward to tomorrow, and we'll have lots of more highlights of the Dyer County Fair.
See you back here, same time, same place, tomorrow night.
That's right.
Thank you for watching Fair, Not Good, Just Fair TV. Your hosts, Debbie Bradshaw Hart and Eric Maupin, will return when they feel like it.